Yeah, you know what? We'll cut it there.
So, guys, how are we doing tonight? Everybody, what's going on? This is the live stream. This is the chill music. This is the hangout music that we're doing. How do you guys like that? 181 of you. Holy shit. I guess when I clickbait these titles to make them appealing, that is just the way we should do it. I'm going to check and see who is tuning in right now. 187 of you. Before I get to everybody right now, I'm just going to say the fucking Chicago Cubs. Yes, that's right. The fucking Chicago Cubs are feeling good tonight. They are winning 6-3. Everybody, this is the first time that it's happened in years. We're watching the Cubs live. You guys are watching me live right now, but that's it. I'm about to bust out the camera here in a few minutes just so I can get you guys on camera. I'm going to lose my fucking mind when this game is over, everybody, so just stay tuned for that. So what do I got tonight, everybody? I just want to ask everybody, by the way, how does the audio sound for this? Because I guess you got a new microphone. Well, hello, everybody. How does my beautiful voice sound? Pretty solid. Does it serious? Can you guys tell a difference? I'm trying to look and see. Sounds great. Sounds great. Sounds good. Sounds good. Madison Killer, what's up, Madison? How you doing? I actually think I sound more sexy already. I can't even hear myself. Can't even hear myself. Sounds like Darth Vader. Darth Vader. Glad that that sounds good. Now, you guys can see we are obviously rocking the Avenged Sevenfold tank tonight for two reasons. Now, two reasons. The new Avenged Sevenfold album is out, and I all suggest you go get it. I'm not a fan of it, of the first or a few songs, I should say, but motherfucker, don't let him score. God damn it. I swear, guys, if this motherfucker 6-4. Sorry, guys. It was just one of those moments. Did you eat 6-4? Sorry, guys. I'm not usually a baseball fan either, but tonight, guys, it's been 1,000 years since the Cubs have won a World Series. Okay. This is important. Very, very important. Damn it. So it's 6-4, everybody. They got to win. But yeah, as I was saying, we're celebrating. Oh yeah, I was going to show you guys. This is the new baby. Check out the new latest addition to the Electric family. Le Schecter. I have two of them. Well, they're in storage. But I decided to go out on a whim and buy a guitar. That's what I was playing for you guys earlier. Well, I'm not going to actually tell you guys what it is because you should know. Shout out to Master Chief. That is the Halo theme song. Oh, fuck, this has got me on edge right now. It's got me on serious edge. So who do we got in the chat? We have I know Madison's in here. Strong fail there. That was not good. Let's see, Erik, you need to cut to the chase. The answer is that you need to do balls deep something ASAP. I have no idea what you mean, sir. But what I do want to get to, everybody, is the fact that I made this title for obvious reasons. What I want you guys to do is to check out the video that was just uploaded about, it's probably 20 minutes ago. I don't know. ADHD is getting to me right now. But you guys should go check out the video. So I went into detail about a few things. I actually took a little hike up to Double Peak. Sorry guys, I think this is like the last part of the game right here. Are you motherfucking kidding me? Jesus Christ, he fucking tied it. This motherfucker. I can't even believe my eyes right now. God damn it. Fuck me. Okay, sorry. Damn it. Okay. I need to ban somebody. This is annoying me. And then I realized that my computer was lacking in battery. Anyways, everybody, so what I did, I'm just going to try to forget that happened. Just going to forget about the game for a second. So I had a rough Sunday, everybody, and fatigue was really getting to me. And I kind of woke up that morning and was just like, fuck, man, I do not feel good at all. Shout out to Sophia. What's up? By the way, you guys hear that noise in the background? That little boom, boom. It's like an email thing. That's really what happens when. So I made that video, for example, and that's all I heard. Oh my God, you got another fucking run. Okay, I'm not gonna look at it. Okay, I want to turn this off. So, anyways. Made the video and everything, and I was just not having a good day. Then I thought about all of the shit that I was used to doing, the masochistic behavior I was used to doing, the just stupid stuff for YouTube and for my own, I don't even know what I want to say. It was just stupid, just what I was doing. So I let it get to me that morning, and so I bust out the camera, made the video, and I got a lot of feedback. And it was a lot of different feedback. Nathan, is that Mr. Figueroa is in the chat? What's up, dude? What's up, Nathan? My boy, Nate Figs. But yeah, so it was hard, guys. It was hard to make that video, but I feel like being vulnerable in that sense was needed. I let you guys see who I am, you know? So, it's better to be honest and be vulnerable in these types of situations. Rather than hide your feelings, you know? And that's kind of like my new goal, my new direction with the chat, the channel. And that's the obvious, you know, answer really, as I'm not going to be quitting. I'm not going to be throwing in the towel. I'm just going to be doing things differently. And that doesn't involve me subjecting myself to what I think and perceive are the desires of my viewers, you know? There's like a difference. I've always said there's a difference between a viewer and a subscriber. You know, subscribers are people that, you know, genuinely care. Like they reach out to me, they ask me questions, they ask me for advice. So, yeah, I just think there's a clear distinction between that. And it was, that's very, like easily seen. If you guys go on any of the comments, on that video, you guys can clearly see who is a subscriber and who is a viewer. It's very, very obvious. I think that people forget that us YouTubers, Nate, since you're in the chat, if you're still in the chat, you can clearly attest to this as well. They forget that we're normal people. You know, we have thoughts, we have feelings, we have emotions. And when you continuously go on and on and on and on and on, and you don't think about your own well-being, that's kind of what got me into this mess. YouTube is, it's a great tool, but it's not, you know, it's not something I should really beat myself up over and continue to do if I don't, like, take time for myself. So that was kind of the main point I wanted to get across to everybody. So, and everyone's going to come in and be like, oh, it's clickbait, it's clickbait, it's clickbait. So that's me describing the so-called clickbait. but you guys get it. I'm honestly, right now I'm just fucking frustrated. Get his ass. Fuck you, dude. Oh my gosh. Fuck. Okay, guys, this is not. Nathan says his comment section's fucked. Dude, your comments, dude, are, I see nothing but your comments, but it's because everyone loves you, man. Everyone just hates me because I'm just that kid that no one likes. Yeah, people, it's very, very interesting. That was the other thing I wanted to kind of go over too, is that people think that, I think it has 600 comments now, but that comment section is literally filled with like 600 doctors. They think they're doctors, you know. By the way, I'm still kind of trying to figure out like what actually is going on with me. I took it upon myself to take a 24-hour break completely of social media, of YouTube. That's why I didn't put up any videos. I had so many people reach out to me, and that was like the biggest thing, like just people that I've never met before sending me emails, sending me everything. Just that was freaking mind blowing. So thank you guys again for that. But I still don't know what's going on. I actually sent an email to my doctor wanting to do blood work, but I was denied blood work. I was denied my request for blood work because of the fact that I did it a few months ago. So therefore, it was deemed unnecessary. To me, that's a little, yeah, I was a little pissed off about that. Yeah, that was annoying. But so after that, I thought, you know what? I'm going to take a complete day-to-day break from any exercise of anything and just kind of go about it like normal. And so apparently Sarah Bueno says, Erik with the CK. Apostrophe RE, a virgin. That was just funny. Come on, guys. If you play guitar in high school, all the chicks, man, it's all they dig. Out of tune, but it's all good. Yeah. So anyways, I don't know, guys. It was very frustrating not be able to get blood work or anything banned. Why did I say banned? I saw somebody get banned. So that's why I said it. Nathan should actually play. No, Nathan should be on drums. So we could actually shred together. But knowing Nathan, he'd probably actually pick up an instrument. Like, if he picked up guitar, he'd probably be better than me at the guitar, because that's what he did with his channel. Like, basically, Nathan Figueroa, I think we had, like, the same amount of subscribers, like, a year and a half ago, and, like, he just blew up and shot all over me, just like that. I was going to play something for you guys, but I forgot what I was going to play. I don't know what I'm doing. That's the Zelda theme song, by the way. I'm trying to remember. I can't remember how to play it. Oh, well. Yeah, so that's pretty much, guys. It's where I was at. I want to show you guys my new guitar, answer some questions, and address the... It is... Nathan, you know, sir, that is the fourth song. You're goddamn right. That's the best song. That's what everybody knows. Madison wants to know what happens if the Cubs lose this. Master. I'm not gonna go into it. Fuck yeah, I just gotta run. Okay, guys. We're back in it. Fuck, I really wish this wasn't happening like this. They could have just, like, won the game 6-4 and it would be fine. It'd be fine. I haven't even looked at, like, what everybody's saying. I'm sorry, guys. I'm being a selfish asshole. Cubs are fucking cursed. Hey, they haven't lost yet. It started raining, though. That's kind of discouraging. So basically, guys, what I've started doing... By the way, I hit a 375 deadlift today for a triple. No belt. That's what happens when you don't ride bikes and you literally just stuff your face with carbs. And then I also want to say, everybody, I am planning to do a challenge tomorrow. It's going to be a big-ass challenge because it is going to be the most food I've ever eaten before. Now, capacity-wise, it is going to be the largest challenge. I'll let the suspense build. Miren Gaines says, what does the title mean? Well, Miren Gaines, you are a little bit late, sir. So you missed the shenanigans. Erik, I like your new electric. Erik, can you critique my squat form? I sure can. I don't even need to see it. All I can say is you're not going low enough. On a side note, for the basketball fans in my chat, my two current favorite team, Lakers and Nets, won. Well, sir, you have good teams because, you didn't say the Bulls on there. So when are you going to travel and meet some fans? I don't have fans. I have subscribers. I don't like to see you guys as fans. I'm just a normal person. But you are, there are viewers and subscribers, though. But Madison thinks I'm at peace with the guitar. I should keep playing. I'm at peace with you. Well, that's not being at peace. It's like in a sexual, like, love with the guitar, which I have been at times. Oh, just get a run, dude. God damn you, motherfucker. Sorry, my language. I should. Oh, I knew that. Okay, so when the Cubs win, you should rock out with the national anthem. I'm going to try to remember. Guys, this is, like, the biggest thing with me. I'm trying to remember how to play all my old songs that, like, I was big on, and it's, like, slowly coming back to me as I get back into it. I played for, like, 8 years, like, on and off. Yeah. Nathan says he feels the same way with the work fans. Nathan knows, and he's going to, I really hope we get a, oh, he fucking stole it. He stole it. Oh, shit. Damn it. Okay. When we do the YouTube house, Nathan, I think you're going. We're going to do an epic eating challenge. For sure. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. What was the first real song you learned to play? I think I'm going to say it was either Mary Had a Little Lamb or the... It was a... Gosh, stop fucking hitting foul balls, dude. Jeez. I'm trying to remember the national anthem right now, but Nathan, so you should start thinking of the challenge that you want to do. E-Rock Rich says, why are you stopping the channel? All caps. Gotta tune in earlier, sir. Managed to put on 2 stone and get up to a healthy BMI, and your videos helped me so much, says Megan. I applaud you, Megan. It's my applaud. It's not even a tune. But yeah, I also will say that you really need to disregard the BMI because it's not... The body mass index, I've talked about this so much. The BMI is just it's just not a good indicator of really anything meaningful, we'll put it that way. So... Find some Metallica tonight. Are you starting a new career and leaving your old one behind? I am not. So I mentioned I did get a promotion. And that involves me being, well, actually, you know what? I'm gonna hide that. Yeah, because it's better that I, just kind of keep that private. Erik, did you hear Joey's World Tour is doing a neck review? That's kind of fucked up, dude. Oh, that's funny. That's pretty funny, though. Are you gonna try to... Are you gonna try to do the big fat fatty challenge again? Yes, I am. That's kind of what the purpose of tomorrow is. I'm just gonna leave it at that. Nathan, have you heard of the big fat fatty? If you're still in the chat, I think you'd be good. Oh, my boy RZ Fitness, what's up, my dude? What up, my friend? The answer to your question, Mr. Raphael. Oh my goodness, you motherfucker! Fuck me, damn it. I hate this right now. Sorry, Raphael, this is a big game right now we have going on. Nathan, you should try... Oh, that's going to be great, Nathan. You're fucking going to be out here during... And we're going to be in Hollywood conveniently. Okay, I already know what we're doing. We're doing the fucking Big Fat Fatty. God damn, that's going to be awesome. Cat Crazy says... Oh, this is great, guys. Hold on. Cat Crazy says, every time you say you're leaving, you're still here. You are such a fucking liar. You also contradict your damn self every other video. Shit. Just go away, you loser. Okay? Oh, man. This is great. When you guys, quick question for you guys, and I noticed this too, like in a lot of research, well, not research papers, but like essays that I that I read and write. But when you say that, like make an argument or say that someone's contradicting themselves, it's usually best, usually, to offer evidence, like an actual contradiction that they supposedly made. I mean, maybe I'm just a little crazy. Maybe, I don't know. I don't know. Guys, it's just usually, it's best to not sound stupid. Anyways, yeah. Ignore the hateful comments because it's 90% love, 10% always remember that. I try. There's a clear distinction, though, between hate and constructive criticism. We'll call it that way. Yeah, Nathan, Madison said, who's not crazy these days? Nathan, you know what, man? It's a big-ass fucking sandwich. I know you know what it is already, but we're going to have to we're going to have to kill that shit, dude. How often do you stream? That is... I know why my live stream got 180 people to start off with. It's because Nathan was in. That's why. Nathan, you need to come every single time I stream, dude. Actually, Sophia, you can join because I think it's going to be during the LA Fit Expo. Erik, the Electric, you should start a guitar lesson channel. I should start a lot of channels. Apparently, I need to start a cycling channel, recipe channel. We continue to do cheat days. I don't know, I move too fast and I'm too lazy to scroll up. Yes, but it's just not going to be what you think. Who's playing? Me. I'm going off the rails on this crazy train. No, I can't say. Makeup tutorial channel. Yeah. I could do it. I could pull it off. Plot twist, he eats the guitar. Madison, she says she feels like an idiot when she wears a bikini. I almost said bikini, but she said beanie. But you put one off. This actually, I'm trying to grow my hair out right now, but I think I look stupid still. I'm just too lazy to do my little swoosh tonight. Nathan says he's confused. I'm trying to make him unconfused. I don't know. Rebecca Snow says, Erik, why no girlfriend or boyfriend? Rebecca, I'm going to say this in my sexual voice right now. Very, very, very slowly. And I want you to listen very, very carefully. I don't roll that way. Yeah, that's just contrary to what people seem to think. Yeah, guys, I had to make the suspense there. I don't do this. I don't. I bet I'm surprised no one's asked why I'm not eating food yet. But I kind of wanted to actually have a paper. I actually was trying to do tonight, but I wanted to make this whole live stream. Yeah, Yeah, Nathan needs to live stream too. If only Erik with a C went both ways. Now, Erik with a C may go both ways, but I'm Erik with a K. So that's... Would you ever play WoW again if you had the time? Potentially. But WoW sucks now. It's not like it was in the old days. You said you are tomorrow. I don't know what that means. Because of you, I'm getting into biking. I'm so excited where I can take it. Shout out to you, sir. Just don't overdo it. It's very easy to. It's a healthy addiction. It can turn into an unhealthy addiction. Chat is moving very fast. Veronica, yes, I do have a paper due as well. So guys, I'm writing tonight on affirmative action and reverse discrimination. If you guys have any thoughts on that, please feel free to post them. Do I know anybody else who spells Erik like I do with the K? Yes, I do. I've met numerous people, but they're all of Norwegian descent, such as myself. Have you ever thought of making a recipe or going channel? I'm assuming you mean gaming. Everybody, I'm playing Battlefield 1 right now, to be honest. Motherfucker. Yes, he stole it. He fucking went. Yes. Ah! Oh. Okay, sorry, guys. He stole her. Fuck me, dude. This game is just getting me going right now. I'd probably just look like a 12-year-old girl who just... Yeah, I'm not going to finish that, but... What was the last thing you ate? Your mother? I had to. I'm sorry, man. I had to. It was just... There was no other thought that came to my mind other than just saying your mother right there. No, I'm sorry. I hope you don't take offense to that, but... gosh, I'm so good. After that little base steal right there, it just went straight into that, and it just chat's going crazy right now with that one. Yes, I was savage, fucking savage. You're gonna do another cycling race marathon? Actually, guys, I'm actually thinking about doing a powerlifting meet. Not trolling it or anything right now. I'm actually thinking about doing a powerlifting meet. I don't know when or if there are any around, but it'd be actually really cool. Powerlifting for me right now is just like fucking awesome. So I'm stoked on it. Sophie Fitness, what's up, girl? 3-2? Are you fucking kidding me right now, dude? Oh my good Lord, Jesus. I even have food in the oven. I haven't even thought about it. Oh, fuck. What? Strikeout? That's bullshit. Please dab for us. I don't dab. Affirmative action does exist. That's why Obama won the election. I understand that it exists, sir, but it's not really about it existing. It's about its implications on... I'm not going to really get into it because I don't want to get political. Erik, do you ever ride BMX? No, I don't. What's in the oven? Food. Logan's going to a partial hospitalization program. What can I give advice-wise? I just have a lot of videos on that. I would actually recommend, depending on when you're leaving, man, send me an email at ErikTheElectric@gmail.com, and I'd be more than happy to email you. Do a pot brownie challenge. Guys, I'm not going to do a pot brownie challenge. That's actually a challenge I think I could die from. I'm doing a capacity challenge tomorrow, everybody. Well, I'm actually, this is another thing that I'm going to try to start doing is when I say things like that and if they don't happen, I expectations are going to be where they are.
Yes! Fuck me, dude. No. Damn it.
I can't. I literally want to turn it off right now. Yeah, so when I say things like that, I don't want you guys to be disappointed if I don't do them. But then again, it's like this little back and forth, like, do I actually give a shit? Obviously, I give a shit if people are upset. But then again, if you're upset about a guy that doesn't do a food challenge, there are some serious issues going on in your life. Serious issues. He looks like a sexy Ellen. Apparently, I'm Ellen DeGeneres. A lot of people like to troll me and say I'm Ellen DeGeneres. I have to take this out of the oven, guys. I think I can smell it. Oh, you guys are watching the ball. This is a big ball.
The sexual jokes tonight, guys.
Oh, gosh. I'm hilarious. Did we burn it? Yeah, we burned it. Shit. Just so you guys, because you'll want to see.
Guess what that is? Guess what it is?
Anyways. Chicken and broccoli. Not quite chicken. I don't know why I did that, but that was kind of creepy. What's your promise for dumps in one day? Is anybody else kind of just like, I don't understand how to comprehend that question. Would you come to the needle walk to participate and perform? Of course I would. National Eating Disorders Awareness Week. I would definitely love to do that. That'd be awesome. Do a vegan food challenge or buy for $1. Good one, dude. Good one. It's not burned, it's blackened. Hell yeah. Bye, Sophia. Anyways, Mr. Nathan Figueroa, we've already established our food challenge that we're going to do. Now, Nathan, I think, Nathan, your capacity is very, I think you have extremely well capacity. Like, you're very, very, I'm sounding like a fanboy right now. But Nathan's, it's cool to see somebody progress through food challenges because, like, when you start doing them, it's like, oh, cool, you know, I'm going to start. But the challenge, I mean, I'm going to do this challenge, blah, blah, blah. You know, just like to start at the first one. Like, for example, like when you guys do, if you do hypothetically your first food challenge, film it. And then, like, you know, you can see, like, based on, like, the person's expression on their face, like, how, like, hard it was. Like, for me, doing the broken yolk was, like, it's like a 6 to 7 pound challenge. And then, like, after that, I was like, shit, like, that's a lot. But that was back in like 2012 or 13, and so now it's like you can pretty much, the last time I did it, I think I've done it 2 or 3 times now, the last time I did it I was like, okay, I want to do 2 next time, you know, just to see somebody like progress like Nathan during that time is pretty you know, interesting. Like, I think he did, like, the first food challenge video I watched from him was like a burrito challenge. So now it's like, it's pretty funny to see. Not funny, but interesting. What is happening to this guy? This guy is making himself look like a fool in front of a giant ball he's speaking into. I have no idea how I sound, but my plan, guys, is to start recording guitar work through my amplifier instead of using instead of using like stock music that I have to like give credit to somebody else for. What's your PR for dumps in one day? I don't poo more than once per day. Matthew Gomez says one time he ate 12 peanut butter sandwiches. I like peanut butter, sir, but that's a lot of sandwiches. Bye, Nathan. Later, buddy. Good talking to you. I have to ban somebody because they're just acting really weird. You're supposed to poo 6 times a day. No, you're not. Funny thing about these general recommendations is that they're general recommendations. You guys have to question everything that you read and see before you take it seriously. Tegan Conway says, I feel honestly sorry for your stovetop. It's taken so many beatings. A lot of beatings, and it sat through a lot of serial reviews. Also sat through a lot of thumbnail taking pictures. Yeah. Where'd you get your nice ass bike? I purchased it. I don't know. I mean, I don't like to steal things. How's your day been? It's been great. Hitting that PR today was fucking awesome. But the Cubs right now are making me want to fucking lose my mind. I probably said fuck more than I've ever said in a day this entire year right now. But I don't care. What's your max bench? Enough. Erik, which frame do you ride? Okay, that was. I ride the giant TCR. You ever tried vaping? I don't do that shit. It's just like, I don't know. I'm just not a fan of cigarettes, vaping, or anything like that. Weed. You should Snapchat your poop so all these people can stop asking about it. Love you, Soapy, but it's not going to happen. I just, not the most attractive thing in the world. I'm trying to get a girlfriend right now. I'm trying to date somebody. I doubt that they'd want to see my fecal matter on my Snapchat. What's the most cereal you eating? I don't know. I love cereal too much to like know that. I don't know. Erik, hate seeing you down. Love your videos. They become a routine to watch. I'm actually not down, Vince, but thank you. Is it hard for you to do the challenge? Bye, Madison. Adios. What's harder for me right now is to see the Cubs go through this. It's very fucking hard. What weight class would you compete in for powerlifting? I believe I would compete in the 85. It's either 85 or 82 kilogram class. I don't know. Just because, guys, when I like don't ride, I gain a shit ton of weight and strength too. Don't get me wrong. Erik, you seem kind of dull compared to your videos. Probably because this is a live stream. And this has been about 51 minutes now, sir. Probably. Freaking watch you more than Netflix, bro. Shout out to Daniel. How much is your rent monthly? Would you also like to know my ID number, driver's license number, license plate number, that as well? I guess I can tell you. Who are you voting for? I'm voting for Nathan Figueroa for president. Actually, Jason Genova. I'm probably going to get Order 66 now. Ridge Reed wants to know my social security. I just saw that Mr. Ridge Reed sent me an email on Big Cartel. So, oh, he struck him out. Fuck yeah. Get off, bitch. Yeah, Ridge, it's honestly, man, right now it's a stretch for me to even get out and do anything other than class. So it's like, I'm really trying to get it out to you though, man. If you want, yeah, we'll get going. Hungry Jack Johnson says, I sent you an email, please read. A lot of emails to get to you, dude. Powerlifting total. I didn't hit the 1,000 club. That was when I was like 200 plus pounds. Oh yes, somebody catch it. Okay, ending's over. Whew. Oh gosh, this is not good. Do you fap? I mean, I think every adult male faps. Is it possible to binge eat once a week and at least maintain weight if you run 6 miles a day, 5 days a week out of the week? If you like structure your diet and lifestyle like that, I feel horrible for you. I really do. Because like that's like the idea, like that, or not the idea, but like the epitome of masochism. Like if you want to like look forward to that as like the primary motivation for your workout fitness, like rigid lifestyle, then I'm sorry, just because like food, and this is kind of like, it's still reinforced to me daily, but food, like literally guys, it's like cool. Like you bite into that apple fritter, like that maple bar, every meal, every piece of food that you eat has an ending. Like it's going to go away. You're going to eat it. You're going to digest it. You're going to poo it out. It's like, I don't know how else to describe it. I've eaten burgers that are like a giant tower, you know, it's like it ends. So that day is going to end. And then like, do you really want to like fall back into like that like rigid lifestyle again? It's like, don't subject yourself to that. Like you're better than that. Can you eat 20 apples? Yes, but I love apples too much to like, I don't like indulging in things like that and like excess that I love. Like I eat daily, like cereal. That's why everybody's like, these cereal challenges, like not gonna happen. Erik, you have cellular, right? I do have a cellular device. It's called an iPhone. Erik is 4'3", exactly world-class douchebag. Have you ever fully diet for more than 48 hours? I'm not gonna address that. What did I do for Halloween? Guys, you know what I did for Halloween? I sat in this very spot right now and played that for Halloween. That is what I did. Zero shits given. What is your favorite flavor of, I mean, generally I like vanilla, chocolate, cotton candy, they have it. Shout out to Crystal. What's up, Crystal? Will you still try to do the big fat fatty? Of course, Crystal. For more explanation, feel free to watch this again when the live stream is posted. How many calories for breakfast these days? Typically, my breakfast has about 1 or 2 calories in it, and it is coffee. It's delicious and nutritious. Anna Butterfly Pro Anna lookup Fort Wayne NEDA walk, please. I think he posted about 7 or 8 times this same exact thing. I definitely am interested in it. It's unfortunately not in California, so I can't like go make a trip out there for something like that. I really would love to though. If it was in California, I definitely would. Would you consider yourself a people person? Generally, yes. Depends on the type of mood I am. But for the most part, sometimes I hate people. I'm not going to lie. Hello to Satan Loves Coffee. Team Cold Brew. Yes, I love cold brew. I'm making my own right now. Do you ever do a challenge with subscribers? I think I have before. I can't really think right now though, so. Is it okay to eat 1,000 calories per day? Sure, not really. Erik, are you ready for Christmas? I'm ready for the holidays to be over. I don't like the holidays. I'm the Scrooge. You live in Cali, right? Yes. Greetings from Azerbaijan. Greetings from America land, sir. What is your favorite coffee flavor? My favorite coffee flavor is coffee. I think one of the biggest disgraces you can actually make in life is drinking flavored coffee. Like that hazelnut bullshit. Every time I see somebody with that ugh, fucking pisses me off. Like in my lectures, I sit down and everyone's got like their Starbucks and a nice little cute little scone. It's like, that's awesome, man, but need to drink a little coffee. And if it's an adult male, notice I say, I don't use the word man. If it's an adult male with flavored coffee, I look over at him and I, in the words of Dane Cook, I go, check out this motherfucker. I look over at him and I'm just like, what the fuck is he doing right now? Yeah. Are you waiting to make YouTube your full-time job / career? Sir, if anybody can make it their job / full-time career, I applaud you. I'm not one of those people. I'm not one of those people. You want Rich Reed? Rich Reed is a fucking beast because he can pay $6 for that cup of coffee. But Rich, if I look like you, man, I wouldn't give a shit. Like if I was Rich Reed and then I was making that face to Rich Reed in a lecture, I'd just laugh and be like, bitch, suck it type thing. Have you had any subscribers or viewers come visit you at your apartment? That's a really good question. No, I haven't. But apparently during my videos, having my apartment number outside my door is my full address. People like to think that people are going to come find me, but I don't think that's possible. Actually, you know what? Anything is possible. Have you been in any bands? Yes, I have. You ever plan on getting to 10% body fat? No, I don't give a shit. I've been at like way lower than 10% body fat. It's not fun. Do you like your current job? Well, I do so far. I did receive a promotion, so I will have to kind of wait on that and see how that goes. Do you love us? I like you, asks Sean Dalton. I love you. Love you, Sean. You should get down to 10% body fat. According to one side, I'm underneath 10% body fat. The other side says I'm over 10% body fat. I don't even know. It depends on the day. What do you guys think? Because it's all in the biceps, right? I'm just going to sit here and do this. Because apparently, it's either about this or it's about your striations. If you guys don't have your striations down, can't be underneath. But I don't know, guys. Just because I don't do this enough anymore, it's about those. Like, is that, I don't know, biceps or these? Tell me what you guys think. I'm just going to sit here and do this. What do you guys think? Am I 10% yet? The moral of the story is don't care. Don't care. Exactly. World-class douchebag put it correctly. Some days I look 10%, others I look 20%. That's the beauty of it. And to me, it's life. You know, you could totally explode a watermelon with those legs. That is my goal in life, sir. That is my goal in life. And my other goal in life, guys, is to watch this game. So I'm going to say goodbye to everybody right now because I'm going to go watch this game and hopefully be shouting tears of joy. I'm not crying. Guys, it has been amazing. Love you all. Thanks for tuning into the live stream. Guys, I want you to go check out the latest video if you haven't already. For further clarification on the title of this live stream, just because I feel like I need to. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's been awesome. Stay tuned for some shenanigans possible tomorrow. Nice little capacity challenge. If you guys have any questions about anything addressed in this live stream you didn't get to, watch the live stream when it gets posted above, or yeah, you guys know what it is. Thanks for watching the video, guys, and world class, go ride. Not a Walmart bike, but a real bike. Love you guys.